Hello, my beautiful people, and welcome back to Nicole's Nutrition Corner. I'm Nicole, and this is your one-stop shop for all things nutrition education, food freedom, and self-care. With all that's going on in the world right now, I constantly get questions about our immune system and how we can eat foods to support our immune system. So in this video, I'll be addressing that, and I'll also be giving you 8 tips and what you can do to support your immune system. I made a blog post about this a little while back, but for me personally, I love watching people and listening and learning. I'm not as much of a reader. So if that's you, keep watching. If you are more of a reader, head over to my blog and you can read everything I'm saying in this YouTube video. So before I can give you the 8 tips, we really need to talk about what it is that your immune system does. So your immune system is super, super important because what it does is it detects and it fights off pathogenic cells or viruses to keep your whole body healthy. It's our immune system that's responsible for fighting off these diseases and pathogens and keeping us alive and healthy. And it's so important for survival. So it's your immune system that prevents you from getting sick. Now, one thing that I see all the time is articles on boosting your immune system. And what I need to say right now is that you can't actually boost your immune system, you can only support it. Unfortunately, there's no evidence to support that a difference in lifestyle factors can boost your immune system. The immune system is a very complex system and it's not just one thing that impacts it. So this is important to note. Although we can support our immune system and make sure it's living up to its full potential, we can't actually boost it and make it do more than it is wired to do or can do based on your own individual body. So there are lots of products and supplements that support this idea that your immune system can be boosted, but it's important to remember that no, this isn't possible, and this is just a little bit of a gimmick to get you to buy their products. So make sure you remember that next time you are looking at a supplement that claims to boost your immune system. It's also been found that actually an overactive immune system can lead to the development of future autoimmune diseases. So we don't actually want an immune system that functions above its capacity because it may not be healthy for us in the long run. So that said, how can you support your immune system to make sure that it remains as strong as possible so that we don't get sick and aren't attracting the common cold and flu viruses? All of the advice I'm going to give you today is essentially just following a healthy lifestyle. And I know sometimes that can be frustrating, and I know you want one answer that's gonna support your immune system, but unfortunately that's just not the way it works, and that's not the way our body works. So number one, eat a nutrient-rich diet. We wanna eat a diet that is balanced and it's rich in all of your micronutrients, and this is important to fuel our immune system. Without it, our immune system doesn't function to the best of its capacity. My recommendation to have a balanced diet is to incorporate fruits and vegetables into every meal, choose whole grains, try to limit red and processed meats, and eat a variety of different protein sources, whether it's meat or it's plant-based. So if you want more information on how to eat a balanced diet, I really recommend looking at Canada's Food Guide. They have a really great visual representation of what a balanced diet looks like. So I'll link that here and I'll also link it below. Number two, it's really important that you are physically active. So getting adequate activity is important for all facets of your health, not just your immune system. Regular activity is important for your blood circulation and your cardiovascular health, which may directly impact your immunity, which is super amazing. If you're wondering how much you should be active every day, the Canada Physical Activity Guidelines recommend 150 hours of activity a week for adults. So if you spread this 150 minutes out over 7 days, that adds up to just 20 minutes a day, which is completely doable. And this can be any sort of activity that you love to do. The third thing that's super important to remember is to get adequate sleep. And I'm sure you hear this all the time, but it's so, so, so important. Chronic sleep deprivation can actually negatively impact your immune system. So when you sleep, your body is making sure you get enough proteins to help support the inflammatory process and help your immune system target those cells that we don't want. So without adequate sleep, you're not making enough of those proteins and you're not helping your immune system. So this is why it's so, so, so important to make sure you're getting sleep each night. I'm sure you've heard it before, but the recommendation is to get 7 to 8 hours of sleep a night. But that said, everybody's different. Personally, I feel like I can't function on less than 8. I need at least 8. I think my ideal number is 9, which is a lot more than some people. Some people can get away with 6 or 7 hours of sleep. Just depends. You just really have to listen to your body. So my tip to you to focus on getting adequate sleep is to really focus on your sleep hygiene. So making sure you're closing your blinds when you're sleeping or reading before you go to bed. Setting yourself up for success before in your nighttime routine is so important so that you have a restful sleep. Okay, tip number 4, wash your hands. I know you've heard it 1,000 times, but the reason why people say it 1,000 times is because people still don't do it. You need to wash your hands. You should be washing your hands for 20 seconds, lathering them with soap. CDC has a really great resource for washing your hands if you want to learn more. I'm sure most of you have already looked at a similar resource, but I'll link it below for you guys so you can check it out if you want to. Some things I wanted to point out here is that you should be washing your hands before and after you're handling your groceries. You should be washing your hands before and after cooking, especially when you're cooking with raw meats. That's super, super important, especially for food safety, which brings me into tip number 5, which is practicing food safety practices. It's important to make sure you're using food safe techniques every single time you're cooking. So this means trying to limit cross-contamination. So if you're cooking with chicken and you're cutting raw chicken on a cutting board here, and you have mushrooms over here that you have to cut up, you don't want to transfer over the mushrooms to the raw chicken cutting board. You want to keep them separate, and that helps you prevent some cross-contamination. It's also, in addition to this, important to be measuring the temperature, internal temperature of your meats when you're cooking to make sure they're up to the standard temperature so that they're safe to eat. And then also back to the washing your hands to prevent any more cross-contamination. There's a lot more different food safety practices. I didn't want to get into them here because we'd be here all day, but I'll link below a really good resource from the Government of Canada that talks about food safety. Okay, are you ready for tip number 6? Tip number 6 is to be aware of your alcohol intake. Research has shown that excessive alcohol intake may impact the functioning of your immune system. It's important to say you don't have to eliminate alcohol from your diet completely. It's just a matter of following the moderate drinking principles that are published by our government. Make sure you're not going too overboard. Canada's a low risk alcohol drinking guidelines state that women should not have more than 2 drinks a night and 10 drinks a week, and men should not have more than 15 drinks a week and 3 drinks a night. I encourage you to either follow these recommendations if you're in Canada or look up your own recommendations in your country and follow those. All right, guys, we're almost there. Tip number 7. Tip number 7 is to not smoke. The nicotine that are in cigarettes can actually suppress your immune system, which makes it not work as effectively. So this puts you at more risk of infection. Therefore, smoking is not recommended for a healthy lifestyle. Okay, number 8, last tip, and I think this is one of the most important ones. This one is about managing your stress. I know this is easier said than done. Trust me, I get it. And this is still an area of research that is evolving, just because stress is so hard to measure and is different for everybody, and everybody shows it differently. Sometimes you're stressed internally, but you don't show it and you don't realize you're stressed. So it's kind of hard to measure in research, but it is something that has research ongoing. But overall, managing stress is an important part of a healthy lifestyle. For me, One way I manage my stress is just having a morning and a nighttime routine that I follow. My morning routine for me is so important. It sets me up well for my day. And then my night routine sets me up well to have a good sleep, which was one of the tips we mentioned before, but also to plan out my next day so that I know exactly what I need to get done to eliminate or reduce my stress levels. I also am a big advocate for talking to a health professional, whether it's a counselor or a therapist. I love talking to a counselor just to check in. It's really great to manage your stress. That's what I do. I'm not saying you have to, but it's something that I really value in my life. So something else that you could include to manage your stress is to just focus on deep breathing or box breathing, if you know what box breathing is. There's a great article from Harvard Health. I'll link it below, and it talks about controlling your breath and working it into your daily routine. So I'll add that for you guys. I read it and I thought it was a really great resource. But yeah, I know that stress can be a hard thing to manage and mitigate, but just implementing little simple effective strategies is gonna make all of the difference. Okay, so just to recap all of the tips for you guys, the first tip is to eat a nutrient-rich diet. Second tip is to incorporate physical activity into your daily schedule. The third tip is to get adequate sleep, 7 to 8 hours a night, depending on the person. The third tip is to wash your hands. The fifth tip is to practice, wow, that was really hard to say, but it's to practice food safe practices when you're in the kitchen. The sixth tip is to be aware of your alcohol intake and try not to go overboard with excessive alcohol. The seventh tip is to not smoke. And then the last tip, of course, is to manage your stress. So I hope that you can go away from this video and understand that you can't actually boost your immune system, but you can support it. And there's lots of different ways you can support your immune system, and they all surround around having a healthy lifestyle. I know this probably isn't the quick fix or the one problem solving answer you are looking for, but I know you can do it. Even just incorporating one or two of these tips into your daily schedule is gonna make all the difference, not only in your immunity, but also in your overall health. Remember that balance and moderation is key when it comes to anything, so incorporate that into your daily life and you will be sure to have some success. All right, guys, that's it for me today. If you have any questions, send me a message. Follow me on Instagram. That's the easiest way to get a hold of me, or you can message me over on Facebook. If you want to know more about nutrition and get more nutrition education, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next Tuesday in my next video.